Hi, and welcome to Horntrader on YouTube. Today, my special guest from the year 1946 is a Martin Committee model. Helicopters. Hate them. All right. 1946, serial number 161031, puts it smack dab in the year 1946. In the serial number range of highly coveted Martins, this is one of them. Made in Elkhart, Indiana. This is a small bore, or medium bore rather. It's 451. And I was doing a little research on these horns, and people used to say that the committee was made up out of Eldon Binge or Dominic Colicchio and Vincent Bach. And I was found here that in 1940, December 1st, in the issue of Downbeat magazine, Martin committees were advertised, and they touted the committee as Fred Berman, who was a popular radio staff trumpet player and very busy in Boston, Kurt Schmeisser, and he was formerly with the Boston and Detroit Symphonies, Jimmy Nielsen, a band director and instrumentalist at Oklahoma City University, Dana Garrett, formerly with the Sousa Orchestra, Reynolds Schilke, we all know that, and Charlie Spivak. So this committee came up with, during the time, and also stood the test of several decades, the best trumpet they could possibly design. And once they got the lead pipe and bell flare together, they decided some of the attributes that these horns should have. One is this nice, big, thick bell bead. You can see that's nice, round, thick. You see it's made in Elkhart, Indiana. Reynolds Schilke's obvious contribution was the reverse lead pipe configuration, which seemed to be crucial because of the small bores that made these horns feel like a little larger bore, gave them a better, more open blow. Very thin bracing, so kind of the horn's focus all centered around this valve section. Big, long, levered water keys, one on the tuning slide, one on the third slide. You could actually use these in one gesture, and you wouldn't get your hands wet. That was smart. A swept back second slide. You can see how that's kind of tucked or swept back so it doesn't stick out and bother you. And then a long and fairly heavy receiver. All these went into the committee, and that made what the horn is today, a highly coveted playing trumpet. So we were just playing a little bit of All Blue, so let's stay with the key of A, and let's check the A scale. You can see it's got a nice warm sound. It's not kind of like that sound that a lot of the Martins had. This horn plays quite well. Let's play a high D. The D's play well in tune. C's. Pretty good compression. I think the vowels probably could be a little more attention addressed to them, but it's got pretty good compression. That's third, first, and high notes, play pretty good on this. It's a very fun horn to play. I would say the lacquer is about 50-60%. And you'd be able to find this horn in the vintage section of Horntrader.com. Thanks a lot for listening. We'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.